cap, packaging. Now let's discuss the difference between the modified atmosphere packaging and controlled atmosphere packaging. So I'm writing here MAP and cap. It is very important because question can be asked from here. So number one, in the modified atmosphere packaging, the gas composition which is being used here is not changed once altered, right? In the MAP technique, MAP packaging technique, the gas composition is introduced only once in a time, whereas in the cap technique, the gas composition is actually produced, not produced, it actually used more than one time once it is altered, right? So here only one time the gas composition can be changed, but in the cap more than one time the gas composition can be changed, right? Second point is, it is less precise, whereas the cap packaging technique, it is more precise than the MAP technique. Third point is, it does not need any provision. The MAP technique, it does not need any provision to alter the gaseous composition, right? Whereas cap technique, it actually uses gas squeezers and gas scrubbers, which actually present all the time to control oxygen and carbon dioxide levels in the food material, right? Fourth difference is, it actually used for the non-respiring food material, whereas cap is actually used for the respiring food material. Fifth difference is, MAP is actually cheap than the cap, whereas cap is costly, right? Next difference is, it is generally used for the long distance transport for mangoes, apples, plums, etc. These type of fruits are mostly processed with the MAP technique, and in the cap technique, it actually generally used for the transportation of apples and pears, and it is less used for different type of nuts packaging and kiwis packaging and avocado packaging. So they are not used for these type of food materials, right? So these are the important difference in the MAP and cap technique. They are very, very important, and questions always comes from this technique, right? Now there are also other methods which are present other than these specific use methods. So other methods here for the food packaging are, number one is called active packaging, right? And in the active packaging, there are actually incorporation of certain type of additives certain type of additives like gases mixtures are actually used inside the food material. Inside the food material, they are also used to increase the shelf life of the food, and they are mostly ferrous oxide or carbon dioxide. Right? The other method for the food packaging is bioactive packaging. Bioactive packaging. Right? It is actually related to the consumer health. Consumer health, and it actually used biopolymers in the packaging material, which are able to withhold desired bioactive principles. Right? So mostly they actually prevents the toxic materials to enter and penetrate the food material into the food material. Right? Then next method is called smart and intelligent method. In this one, it involves different type of biosensors, different type of monitors to check the food quality of foods. Right? These are called, number one, for example, time temperature indicators or rapid frequency identification. So these type of indicators, they actually tells if there is need of introduction of different type of other preservative methods in the packaging. Right? So in this segment we discussed about the different type of packaging techniques, in which we saw the vacuum packaging technique, we saw the aseptic packaging technique, then we discussed the MAP and CAP techniques, which are important. All are important, but these are very, very important. Right? Then we discussed about other methods. So you need to remember all of these techniques for your GATE examination.